I'm repping my Africa to the World t-shirt, which means that we are not giving up on this movement. Africa to the World is here to stay. And anytime I talk about Africa to the World is here to stay, it's because I'm seeing the impact. I'm seeing my brothers, my sisters repatriating back to the continent, and which makes me rejoice in my heart. My brother.
Yes, sir.
Good to see you, man.
Likewise.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, sir. Bless up.
Oh, you know, I met them in Rwanda, Africa. They were like, what am I at? I've been watching your videos. I was like, wow. Where are you from?
I'm from the States, Alabama, to be exact. We are here in Ghana now, so I'm excited.
You are here in Ghana. Like, what are you doing in Ghana?
Oh, we are farming here. We came to farm. We've been here since 17, and we just want to provide food for our people, the right kinds of food. So
we do all organic.
All organic?
Mm.
Wow. So you moved to Cape Coast.
Mm.
But you know, like, Africa is huge. Africa has 55 countries. You could have gone to any country in Africa. Why Ghana?
Basically, Kwame Nkrumah, everything he did, you know, to reach out to the diasporans. He didn't have to make English the national language, but he saw us coming in the future. So he did that one just to help us communicate as continental Africans and the diaspora. So the elders and the ancestors saw it coming. So they made way. And Kwame Nkrumah is a big inspiration.
Both of you look alike.
Yeah, we are twins.
Oh, twins?
Yes, sir.
I didn't even know that. I thought like maybe family, but family, but twins. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
First time interviewing twins, though.
Respect.
Like, do you know your local name? Like in Ghana, twins, we have names we call them.
Yeah. I'm Atapinin. That means the elder twin.
Okay.
Atapinin, yeah.
Oh, so you are?
Atakakra.
Oh, my goodness. Like,
yes, sir.
You've registered this name already?
Yeah. We had to go change the name, naturalize it. Everything is good. We went to Takoradi there for that one.
You went to my hometown.
Takoradi.
That's my city, man.
I love Takoradi. I love it.
I'm so glad that both of you are really enjoying Ghana. Let me know, what is the experience like being in Ghana?
Oh, we love it. The people are warm and inviting. You know, everybody's like a Kwaba, so we did chop fufu with everyone. You know, we meet a lot of families. We've been traveling around quite a bit. Kumasi, Takoradi, Cape Coast, Volta region. You know, we're just trying to see all of Ghana. We plan to travel north to Tamale in December. So we just have a lot of stuff to see. Ghana's big and plenty going on.
Wow. Like, I'm so happy, man. You guys have no idea. And exactly. I just want to know, like, you know, you're a Rasta man in Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
I know my people.
Yeah.
They have names that they call Rasta man. Like, when you're walking in the street, how do they call you?
Oh, it's always Rasta.
You guys, I got this from Native Born. I don't know if you guys know Native Born. The first I interviewed Native Born, they're like, in Ghana, everybody call me Rasta. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to know if you have the same experience.
Yeah.
But do the people, how do the people relate to you?
It's different strokes. Different people respond differently. I know a lot of the older people, they don't really understand that this, you know, it's the expression of Africanness in the stateside. We had a lot of people chop their hair off. A lot of people aren't accepted for wearing, you know, traditional African styles and stuff. So coming to Africa and be able to express your African roots and everything is love. But, you know, some of the older people, they don't really understand.
I want to call you that you're an African. Both of you are an African born in America.
Mm-hmm.
Will you accept that?
Yeah, of course. That's what we are. Everybody can look and see Africa.
When we're in Africa, we blend in with everyone. So
wow. So which means that since you came to Ghana, you've blended in. No one can even, unless you talk before
that's
somebody.
It. No one knows. They don't even know. They say, oh, he's Ghanaian, and you just go your way.
Wow. See? What is the message that you're going to tell young Africans born in America, born in Jamaica, born in, you know, the African diaspora? Is there any message you have for them? Like,
okay, basically, I just want to say that the Black Star is welcoming to anybody from the diaspora. It's not easy, but it's better, from my personal experience. So if you are a younger person and you have a plan, you have something on your mind that you want to do, come to the continent. And, you know, like I said, if you don't like Ghana, there's plenty of countries to go.
Exactly. What about anything, you? Anything
same thing, you know, you know, see the world, see more of Africa, travel. You know, if you don't like the States or the diaspora for how they treating you
Africa is for Africans. You can come home, you can be amongst your people them, and learn your culture.
I don't want you guys to go. Yeah. Hold on. Mm. The image you had for Africa some time ago, like when you were back in the state, is it the same image that you've seen over here when you came here?
Oh, no, no.
No, it's a lot different.
It's very different.
How different?
Oh, they just told us that, you know, everybody was sick and, you know, starving. Everybody was starving.
Everybody have HIV, everybody disease.
And then when you get here, you know, you see everybody, it's like, oh, come eat with me, you're invited. I'm like, if you are poor and you're hungry, why would you invite me? So
there's plenty of food, everybody's eating, nobody's starving at all.
Nobody's starving.
So we all can't believe that they lied to us. Mm, and they're still lying.
They're still lying. Okay.
Thank you so much for helping me to change the narrative.
Thank you, man. Thank you,
I appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I love you, bro.
Love you, man.
I love, man.
Love.
I help Maya. Peace out.